whatever happened to bowing, you know? Get on stage, take a bow, such a nice thing to do. Respectful, humility. I used to learn to bow when I was in primary school in Chong Hua. Every time teacher walks into the classroom, everyone will stand up and go, "Good morning, teacher." Class ends, "Thank you, teacher." I remember primary school teachers, they are all very, always in a good mood, right? Every time they walk in, they see a room full of people just bowing to them. I guess that helps. They would enjoy life a little bit more better than us. But kids today, they don't, the art of bowing is lost on them. If you ask a kid to go on stage, introduce themselves, they go, "Hi, my name is Raymond." And you all remember how Zainal used to do it, right? "Hi, my name is Zainal." I'll tell him you remember. The only people who still bow today are Japanese people, right? It's so ingrained in their culture. They emphasize on politeness and respect. When it comes to customer service, maybe that's why they are ranked on top. Right? You have Japanese, followed closely by Taiwanese, and then there's the rest of the world, and then there's the US. First time I went to the US many, many years ago, I was asking for direction, I was asking for help from somebody passing by. I'm like, "Excuse me, sir, can you help me?" He's going, "Can't you tell I don't care?" "Sorry, officer." In Japan, it's different. Like, if you are a guest in their country, you ask them a question, they try not to answer with "no" or "I don't know." They will do their best to give you the right answer. I found this out when I got lost in Tokyo, walking around looking for a shop name. I only have the name. And I asked a passerby, "Excuse me, sir, can you help me find this shop?" He's looking at the name and he goes, "Oh." For a good minute. And then he sees another fellow Japanese passing by. He's calling to him. And they're both speaking Japanese, going, "Ah." This went on for 5 minutes. I didn't know how to communicate with them, but finally I couldn't take it anymore. I'm like, "You don't know where this is, do you?" And both of them went, "Yes." You have to ask them a question that the answer is yes, not no. Sometimes if they have to say no to you, they would also come up with like a cute hand gesture, just to maybe soften the negativity, I don't know. So this is their no. You might have seen it before, right? So I'm wondering back then, like, if this is a no, like an X, what is a yes? What's the hand gesture for yes? So I'm thinking, what's the opposite of a cross, like an X? It must be a tick. Right? Like a Nike swoosh sign. So the hand gesture must be... You see the tick? But nobody uses that there. Just me. They also cannot accept tips. Like, it's an insult if you give them a tip for doing a good job, giving you good service, because to them, that is what they're supposed to do. So you don't have to tip them for it. I didn't know this. First time in Japan again, I checked into a hotel room, misplaced my passport somewhere. The staff found it, brought it up to my room. Naturally, I wanted to tip him for as a thank you. I took out some money, and he's like, "No." I'm like, "Yes." And he's like, "No." And I'm like, "Yes." And he went, "No, no." And I'm like, "Yes, yes." He's like, "No, no." I'm like, "Yes, yes." No, no. And then later on, I found out that they cannot accept him. And I'm like, oh. I thought back to that guy just now. I'm thinking, poor guy. He must be so confused. He just did a good deed. And yet, I'm punishing him. Yeah, the irony. Don't you just love cultural differences? I'm punishing him by forcing him to take my money. Where else in the world will this happen? In Brunei, I mean, you would offer me a tip. I'm like, no, I'm always like, okay. Tipping in different countries is a very different ways to ask for tips. In Brunei, I mean, we just put a tip jar. Hope people will give us tips. In our neighboring countries, they will create things for you so that you will tip them. I was in Jakarta. I have rented a car, bad mistake. It's always so jammed. And sometimes the jam is so long, you can't move. And then, out of the blue, some guy will come to your car with a spray and a cloth and start cleaning your windshield. And you can't do anything because they're outside, you're inside. I was going, get them out. And he's like, check in. Belakang juga. In Malaysia, it's a psychological warfare. I remember I was with my friend, he was driving me to this restaurant in KL. And then beside the restaurant is an empty plot of land for parking. We went around a couple of times, finally found one. And my friend reversed his car. And then a random guy jumped behind the car and went, Lagi. Just when my friend decided, okay, that's enough. And he stopped the car, put the handbrake in. The guy went, oh! By the way, what is oh? Where did OP come from? Like, are we as people have become so lazy that we don't want to say stop? Just stop. I don't know, is it okay? So anyway, the guy went on. And then we went on the car, and the guy gave him like 2 ringgit. And I'm like, why do you pay him for something that you're already doing? And my friend's like, it's okay lah. I'd rather give him the 2 ringgit now, then come back later and discover all 4 tires have become donuts. So draw the line at donut jokes. Okay, sorry. No donut jokes. Anyway, where was I? Alright, donuts. In the US, tipping is a ridiculous thing. You must tip them at least 10%, no matter the service, good or bad. Did you know that? I didn't. And if you are in a group of 6 or more, you have to tip them at least 15%. I didn't know this until I was there. But I was sitting in a diner, having a meal. After I'm done, I asked for the check, right? Waitress brought it to me. It cost like $17.50. I gave $20, and I waited for the change. I'm calling the waitress again. I'm waiting for my change. After a while, she brought the change, threw it on the table, and said, "You are being very rude." I'm like, what? What did I say? It's not what you say, it's how you said it. What? How did I say what? You're supposed to give me a tip. And then she walked off. I'm thinking, what just happened? Okay, it's not what I said, it's how I said it. So I decided I'm going to talk to her in the nicest way possible. I stood up, went to her, I I said, "Ma'am, excuse me, you do not deserve a tip." Yeah. Have you ever, like, finished an argument with a bow? There's not much you can do after that. You bow and then you walk off. Like, the bowing is the driving full stop, but there's no hours around it. Like, if you were to come up to me after this show and say, "Excuse me, I don't think you're funny," I would be like, "What? Why? What did I do? What did I not do? I'm not gonna sleep tonight." But if you came up to me and went, "I don't think you're funny," I'm like, "Okay. It's good to receive honest feedback.
Yeah.
I'll do better next time." I was recently, this is a recent story. I was in Bangkok. I was on a budget trip. I was going around in a Grab car service. But then, when I was there, I realized there's Grab bike as well. And it is much cheaper. Problem is, I've never been on a bike. And I'm terrified to go on a bike. So I began to observe first. Like, I was in the Grab car, I was looking around, and I see all those bikes. They are like scooters, right? Scooters that doesn't really go very fast. And when you sit down, it's like that, right? And then I saw the passengers, they were sitting behind, like, there's this kid, teenage boy. He wasn't even holding on to anything. He was holding on to his phone, and he was going, catching Pokemon. And then I saw another bike with a lady behind it. She wasn't sitting like that, she was sitting like sideways, her legs crossed, eating tom yum soup. I'm thinking, how dangerous can this be? And all these scooters, right, they have like a small handlebar for the passenger to hold them back. Okay, I'm gonna try it. I called for a Grab bike, but when it came, it was a sports bike. A sports bike, meaning the seat is inclined, goes up, and the handlebars of the rider is lower than the seat. So the rider would be like this. I thought, this can't be happening to me. What luck. And I thought, it's too late to change now. I mean, too late to cancel, right? Especially when he passed me the helmet and I put it on.
What is
it? And I said, "This is my first time." And he said, "Oh, okay. You want medium or fast?" "Can I have slow?" "Okay, medium." And I looked at the bike. I'm like, how do I climb up? And he pointed to the step. So I said, "Okay." So I climbed the board. First thing I noticed, I was taller than him. I could see everything. Second thing I noticed, I have never been this close to another guy. I mean, he was right here. I reached to the side for the handlebars, there were none. I didn't know what to do with my hands, so I went. Straight. And he took my hands off. Putting on his shoulders. And off we went.
Oh, yeah.
If this was medium, I don't want to know what fast is. He was zigzagging into the road. He was cutting cars, I mean, he was the fastest vehicle on the road. I was hanging on to dear life. Every time I feel like he's gonna hit something, I'm trying to control the bike with his shoulder. I'm like, and every time he squeezed in between two cars, I was so afraid my knees are gonna hit the cars. Reflex action went like this. Essentially, I was squeezing him with my inner arm. He looked at it and then he passed me back 200 baht. He said, "It's okay. You can put massage."